Oh, Peggy Purey Cust, how pure you were. My first and purest love, Miss Purey Cust. Satchel on back, I hurried up West Hill to catch you on your morning walk to school, your nanny with you and your golden hair streaming like sunlight. Strict deportment made you hold yourself erect, and every step bounced up and down as though you walked on springs. Your ice-blue eyes, your lashes long and light, your sweetly freckled face and turned-up nose so haunted me that all my loves since then have had a look of Peggy Purey Cust. Along the grove, what happy, happy steps under the limes I took to bower and house and blob work, weaving, carpentry and art. Walking with you, and with what joy returned. Wendy you were to me in Peter Pan, the little match girl in Hans Andersen, but I would rescue you before you died. Once you asked me to your house to tea. It seemed a palace after 31. The lofty entrance hall, the flights of stairs, the huge expanse of sunny drawing room, looking for miles across the chimney pots to spired St. Pancras and the Dome of Paul's. And there your mother from a sofa smiled. After that tea, I called and called again. But Peggy was not in. She was away. She wasn't well. House of the Sleeping Winds, my favorite book, with whirling Art Nouveau and Walter Cranish color plates, I brought to cheer her sick bed. It was taken in. Weeks passed and passed, and then it was returned. Oh, gone forever, Peggy Purey Cust. Mm-hmm.